Good afternoon. My name is Logan Clark, and I'm going to talk to you today about Newton's laws of thorn recoil. Newton had three laws. First law, an object at rest stays at rest, and an object in motion stays in motion with the same speed in the same direction unless acted upon by an unbalanced force. The second law, the force acting on the object is equal to the mass of that object times its acceleration. The third law, for every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction. Well, how do these laws relate to thorn recoil? Well, I'll get to that. What is thorn recoil? Thorn recoil is the actual kicking motion or rear motion of a firearm that happens when a bullet is fired. Newton's first law, as you recall, says an object in motion stays in motion, and an object at rest stays at rest. Same thing with firearm. A firearm stays at rest and remains at rest until you pull the trigger. Then it comes into motion. The reason it comes into motion is because of the ignition force of the actual round being fired. And Newton's second law. This law builds and follows recoil in the sense that an acceleration is created on the bullet when the powder charge is ignited inside the casing. Heavier bullets require more force than lighter bullets because a heavier bullet is heavier and it takes more propellant to send it downrange at an effective velocity. Take a .308 Winchester, for example. It shoots a 150-grain bullet, and a .223 Remington shoots a round of 67-grain bullet. As you can see right here, the .308, it has a larger case because it requires more powder to push the heavier bullet downrange compared to that of the .223 right here on the left. Newton's third law. The forward motion of the bullet leaving the firearm is equal to the rear motion of the firearm. The bullet leaving the barrel is your action force, and the rear motion of the firearm or recoil is your reaction force. And I'd just like to take a moment to thank you for